Andy House would like to introduce the story Cold Wind on the Wild Mound, based on the true story in the western region, South Vietnam. The last chapter, the end. It was not until 3 days later that Mr. Nam's body was found in the mound. His dog bites a lapel, leads everyone to come. Nobody wants to go there to find him. They gathered and went in. From a distance they saw him in his posture kneeling on the mound. When it came to look, the corpse was hard, curling up, hands clasped to the chest. His face twitched to distortions. His white eyes seemed to protrude from his face. Everyone is silent. The atmosphere encompasses fear. No one dares to say anything. They avoided giving Mr. Moy a close look. He looked closely. On the corner of Mr. Nam's mouth, there was a trail of dried blood flowing down his neck. He said the people to support the corpse lying down. But strangely, the convulsive body couldn't pull it straight. Because of the blazing sunshine, or because this place's death was too heavy? Mr. Moy was dizziness. He looked at the dead man's face. What did he see? What caused such a horrifying death? Mr. Moy looked around. Suddenly there was the sound of dog barking. Mr. Nam's dog. It found something on the other side of the mound. He and a few people came to see. They saw an old woman lying on the ground. He hurriedly supported her. The old woman was in a coma. Only the breaths of the dying person. Her body was dry and small like a child. Her face was dark with wrinkles. Mr. Moy called out. He heard a wheeze in her neck. He dropped his ear and heard in between hiccups, "Blood debt to pay with blood." She smiled, a horrid smile, then stopped breathing. Mr. Moy took her hand, took her pulse and shook his head. In one hand she dropped an object. He picked it up. It is a green jade necklace engraved with Nam. He looked closely to see this character very familiar, which was engraved on Mr. Nam's chest. He sat there and looked at the old lady. Suddenly he seemed like he was awake. He realized that her legs were ripped. He thought, perhaps this is Mrs. Chin. Where has she been during the past 20 years? People seem to ignore this woman because Mr. Nam's horrifying incident is happening before their eyes. The story of Mr. Nam biting his tongue and dying at Chin's mountain soon spread throughout the region. People talk about it fearfully, whispering to each other in the markets. Mr. Nam's death made the fear of the place even bigger. It's been a long time since such a terrible thing happened. And the story is repeated a long time as to prove more profoundness of this land. Almost nobody mentioned the death of an elderly woman with a leg amputated. The specter of ghosts in that place overwhelms all. But Mr. Moy did not forget. On Mr. Nam's shroud, he placed the green jade necklace on the crumpled corpse before closing the lid of the coffin. Old masterpiece. Then put the old lady into a small grave. No one knew who she was, from where she came from. Only Mr. Moy recognized her. Late afternoon. Red sunset is on the horizon. The wind was cool. Mr. Moy put the teapot on the table, stroking soft hair of two, his daughter. Suddenly Mrs. Moy came out, complaining. I just went back to the neighborhood. Everywhere I go, I heard about Mr. Nam. Everyone is afraid that someone will be shocked again. Mr. Moy said nothing, musing over the empty space. Is Miss Chin's mound with ghosts? He was not sure. Because there are things he thinks forever. There are things buried in the grave, but he knew that no one would have to leave their lives there because of her unjust soul. Only one person had to leave his life. It was Mr. Nam. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to support Andy House. See you guys in the next videos.